Thanks, Chitra and Harshul. So we are actually before starting on time. We are starting before time, 5 minutes before. So we are today at the crossroads of where we were, say, 15 or 16 years ago with FACO. If you came to the All India 15 years ago, and all the courses were converting from ECCE to FACO, and now soon the time has come for FACO emulsification specialist to convert to femtosecond laser cataract surgery. So how do you do this? Just because you have access to a machine, it's not as simple as just starting out, and it's a whole new surgical technique with its own challenges. So that's what we have to see. So I'm going to start the topic, transitioning to femtolaser assisted cataract surgery, FLACS. I wish I was I had some financial interest, but I don't, so I have to pay for my own ticket to AIOS. Now, what's important when learning a new surgery? The first thing is learn the machine and its settings yourself. If you are permanently dependent on the technician, then you are never going to actually understand what's going on. So once you have the manual with you, you must read the manual and figure it out. Practice on grade 2 to 3 cataracts first. You need to learn this surgery on a widely dilated pupil. So you must pre-medicate with enough Bromfenac and dilating drops. And naturally, cases like posterior polar cataract, subluxated lenses, etc. are not the cases to learn FLACS on. So the clinical advantages of femtosecond laser are very simple. First of all, you get a deadly rexis. You get perfect lens fragmentation, and then you have access to do LRIs. The rexis is very, very good and precise, and despite all the controversies, etc., we've been doing femtosecond laser cataract surgery now more than 2.5 years, and the rexis is absolutely perfect. And this is one of the stellar advantages of the technology, is that however hard the case, subluxated, etc., etc., rexis is one thing you can be sure of. The lens fragmentation makes a quick work out of a hard cataract, the type of cataract that you should look at and you have to dig out all the sharp chopper. Next day, all SKs, patient complaining. Next day, with a femtosecond laser cataract surgery, if you applied the technology properly, you will find that your cornea will be rather clear and you will be surprised how fast the eye recovers. The catalyst system that we use doesn't have a plate, it has a liquid optics interface. So this makes it very easy to dock. You don't need a speculum most of the time if you have a slightly cooperative patient. So let's see some videos. Transitioning to FLACS, the first video. So basically, once the patient is docked under the machine, the first thing that you will see is this kind of interface on the screen. And the machine takes multiple OCTs and generates a three-dimensional model. So this is what the view that we get when we are doing the surgery. The anterior and posterior surface of the cornea, anterior and posterior surface of the lens, and the iris. So that you know how big your rexis can be, you can make your rexis just a little smaller than the pupil margin. Naturally, you can't have a rexis larger than the pupil margin because it's not going to go through the iris. So once you've approved it, you decide the fragmentation pattern. After using a lot of patterns, I kind of decided on this. So you can adjust the way that you want to do the lens fragmentation. And once you press the pedal, rexis is over in less than 2 seconds. And the rest of the procedure is completed in about 30 seconds. So this is the advent of new technology, and it will come. It's only a matter of time. This is what it looks like. This is the patient that we just put under the system. And these are the large chunks that we create. I used to create a very small fragmentation pattern, but I found that FACO actually went easier after this. We always do a nice hydro dissection, and there's a lot of air bubbles sometimes trapped underneath that come to the surface. Now the interesting thing is, I want you to look at the video overlay, and what you'll see is that the amount of FACO power you end up using, this would have been a grade 2 to 3 cataract, is nearly zero. I'm using 2 and 3%, which basically means I'm in foot position 2. You very rarely have to go actually to foot position 3. And that's the benefit of the technology, is that you will get absolutely clear cornea the next day. This is just flipping the epinucleus. And just engage it. Again, you hardly need any phaco power. You probably use 1 or 2 seconds of phaco power in the entire procedure. And that's why you get a very clear and nice cornea. And that's the end of it. You can see that you have an absolutely clear cornea. Now, the one interesting thing when you're learning this surgery is that you have to relearn how to do cortical cleanup. So you have to go in the fornix of the bag and peel the cortex towards the center. This is something that you didn't have to do with phaco, because it would have a cortical frill. So this doesn't have a cortical frill. This has got a punch, because it has punched the rexus and the anterior cortex. So what happens is that you have to go into the periphery of the cortical bag and peel the pieces out, which is why when you're learning the surgery, you don't want a small pupil case, which will make your life hell in the beginning and give you a nice capsular rent sometimes. So if you want a nice smooth learning experience, learn the surgery on dilated pupils, just like cataract surgery. That's the lens in the bag, perfectly centered in the femtorexis. Let's have a look at the next. So this is a little video I made putting together different fragmentation patterns and how they affect the outcome. So this is one of the first fragmentation patterns I used, was multiple very small pieces. Now this is what you would use in a grade 2 cataract, something like this. So once you've converted into this kind of a very softened cataract, all that you have to do is put your tip in. If you notice, the chopper is not doing anything, you're just doing irrigation and aspiration. Again, you're left with your cortical frill, and you have to go to the periphery of the bag and pull that cortex out. So that's one of the only challenges of learning the surgery, is relearning a little bit how to do your cortical cleanup. That's the lens inside. Now the next case I want to share, which will come up now, is a small pupil, rock hard cataract. So we did a 5 millimeter rexus, because that's all we could get. The person couldn't be given a block. She was on blood thinners. So we did it topical. So you can see the eye is moving. So this was one-eyed, very hard cataract, small pupil and high myope. So in we go. Again, you have to do a nice purposeful hydro dissection in this manner. And here you do have to use a little bit of phaco energy, but just enough to embed. So you notice that as soon as you attack the lens with the chopper, it forms 3 or 4 pieces, because you've already got a cleavage plane. And most of the time the chop goes through and through. So again, all that you do is, if you approximate the chopper, you will get exact 4 quadrants, because that's the fragmentation pattern that we used. Again, this kind of a situation, you would have had quite a lot of SKs the next day. But here you will not get that. You will get a very nice and clear cornea. And if you see at the end of it, once you flip the epinucleus, you can see that the red glow is not very red. It's a very, very high myopic eye. This was a -5 IOL that we had to put in. So when you have this kind of a situation with a small pupil, always remember that you can still do femtosecond laser cataract surgery. If the pupil is 5 millimeters or bigger, that's good enough. So that's the poor glow that you get there, the typical yellowish glow of a high myope. Again, you have to go to the fornix of the capsular bag and peel the cortex. That's why you have to put in the pupil hooks. Otherwise, sometimes you will end up engaging the capsular bag. And that doesn't have very good consequences. Just clean the viscoelastic underneath. And the final case that will come up will show us the main advantage, is that you don't have to make tiny little holes and do all that with a wide cataract. And you'll have to go to Argentina to get an Argentinian flag sign, because this will give you a perfect rexus every time. So however intumescent the cataract, however dense, however mature, however white, in about 2 seconds you will get a perfect rexus, and that makes everything that much easier. Even though it doesn't really penetrate white cataracts, what we find is that it creates a cleavage planes, which you can see. So you get that through and through snap like that. And that makes everything much easier. This pupil persistently kept going down, as I'll show you. And by the end of the case, we find the pupil is nearly shut. So in this kind of scenario, what do we do? So once you've done a lot of femtosecond laser cataract surgery, you have a feel for where the capsular bag will be anyway. And once you've got the epinucleus and the last bits of nucleus out, the trick is not to go into the periphery just now, and just keep the tip in the center and wait for it, and that's it. Everything's over, but you still have to go to the fornix of the capsular bag and pull it out. Let's have a look at the next one. And this is a rock hard cataract. So this is the kind of cataract which otherwise you'd get sleepless nights over, and you'd want to do SICS instead of doing a phaco. But here, if you have access to a femtosecond laser, it will fragment it like this into 8 pieces, and you'll get a perfect rexus. So again, nice dilated pupil, get the air out, and now you can see, you do need a little phaco energy to embed, but once you do, you will get a perfect split like this down the femtosecond plane that the laser has created. So all that you have to do is spin it around and split the pieces apart. The part of this video I wanted to show you comes a little ahead. Here we go. So you have to go into the fornix of the bag, and while doing that, you can see that over here, you can see the pointer. We have engaged the capsular bag while going and torn it. So this is one of the possible pitfalls, where if you have to go to the fornix and go and collect cortex, you can potentially engage the capsular bag in this manner and you can get a rent. So no surgery is 100% foolproof. Eventually you have to go in the eye and do the surgery, even though a lot of people may market it as a 30-second procedure, etc. You still have to do the surgery. So you have to remember that you will have to go in the fornix, and if you think it was difficult, then you should put hooks or put a pupil ring at that stage and then do a irrigation aspiration. So these are the different stages of learning the surgery I wanted to show you. And now let's go on to Dr. Keki Mehta next, and he's going to speak to us on his experience with femtolaser cataract surgery.